So we are going to present on faith and
fear. Would you please put the microphone always nearer to your mouth? Like this. Yes.
So we are going to present on face and fingerprint recognition biometric technologies. So in this, the major topics are, so the first three topics are going to be discussed by me, and the next face recognition technology is going to discuss by Lata, and then Chandramouli, and then conclusion by Sachin. So coming to what is biometrics? So as we know that bio means of life, it is a Greek word, and metrics means measurable. So biometrics is an authentication technique that rely on measurable physiological and individual characteristics. So physiological and individual characteristics are some of the attributes. So the attributes are some hands, face, or iris, retina, are some of the attributes each and individual have. So by using this, we can perform some identification technologies. So these are biometrics. So why we go for biometrics? So it is because the authentication and authorization are becoming necessary for many everyday actions. Like, so if you want to pick a child from your child from daycare or something in airports, performing some financial transactions or accessing some facilities like entering into parks, or if you want to enter into a rec center, you need to be authorized. So in authorization or in authentication, why we go for biometrics? So this because of these two main reasons. The first one is biometrics provide high degree of certainty. So by using this, we have 100%, not exactly 100%, but most accurate results. And the second thing is these biometrics are directly or indirectly related to cost saving. So it reduces risk of financial losses. So it is better to have $500 biometrics rather than losing some $1,000 or $10,000 valuable files. So what are the types of biometrics? There are two types, physiological and behavioral. Physiologicals are measured at some points like finger, hand geometry, or iris, retina. These can be measured and they are going to be stay with you entire your lifetime. And then coming to behavior, so these depends on the state of mind. So like signature, voice, gait. If you are signing 100 or 500 signs, your sign may change. So coming to voice, your voice pitch may change depending on your sadness or happiness. So mostly the physiological are more accurate than compared with behavioral. So the working of these almost biometric technologies are like this. So there will be a database, enrolled database, and then data acquisition, and template, the score, and the threshold, and decision. These are some of the major attributes. So enrollment is the persons who are going to be identified. They need to be enrolled previously. So whenever he wants to enroll or prove his identity, he need to present the data, biometric data, such as fingerprint or his iris or his retina. So the presented biometric data is converted into template. So the system is going to be compare the digital data, not the image. So it is converted into ones and zeros. By using these ones and zeros and already enrolled data, a score is generated, and this score is compared with the threshold value. This threshold value is set by the administrator of the biometric system. So the scores are compared with the threshold value. If score is greater than threshold, and he is authenticated and he is approved to use the system or enter into system. If score is less than threshold value, then he will be rejected. So this is a basic working thing of almost all biometric system. So now the face recognition technology is going to discuss by Lata.
Hi friends, this face biometric system, each and every day we use face for recognizing other humans, and it uses features of the face to verify or identify the individuals. Even though we are in a crowd, face recognition will identify the face. And here there are five steps for facial recognition. First, it captures the image. From that image, it will separate the face, and it extracts the features from that face, and the features will be stored in a template. And if he's enrolling for the first time, it will store the template and he is enrolled. And if he is coming for the second time, It will compare the template which has taken already and the live features which has taken now, and it will declare the matches based on the threshold similarity scores. And it works, it uses high resolution cameras and moderate lighting on the face. While doing the face recognition, the user should be close to the camera and proper angle will be setted, and darker and white skins can be more difficult to enroll. Here there are some features which does not change over time, like upper edges of the eye sockets, areas under the around the cheekbones, sides of the mouth, nose shape, position of major features related to each other. Difficulties in this face biometrics are these are the twins, and this is father and son. They have similar features which causes difficulty to identify. And this is intra-class similarity. Here, the same person, if he changes the position or lighting, or if he gives a big smile, then the features will be changed. Challenges here are, if he gives a big smile, the features will be different when compared to the normal face. And if he has a mustache or facial hair, or coloring chemicals, or if he had some makeup, it will cause difficulties. The template size is more for facial recognition, which is a challenge. It is used in applications like logging into the system and mobile identification and for check cashing. That's it. My friend will discuss fingerprint.
Coming to fingerprint, this is one of the oldest fingerprint recognition technology compared to the face recognition. Fingerprint is nothing but a bunch of lines which has a fixed pattern that are aligned with each other. And these fingerprints lines are permanent and they never change in the lifetime of a person. Fingerprints are usually classified based on the 7 criteria that are shown. They are crossover, core, bifurcation, rejoining, island, and delta and pore. These are the finger ridge configurations, and the finger scanner extracts these configurations from the input device. These are the common fingerprint sensors that are usually used. Typical fingerprint scanners are optical, silicon-based capacitive sensors, ultrasound, and thermal. Optical sensors usually use near-infrared or UV light to capture fingerprint image. Silicon-based capacitors uses electrical pulses from the finger. And ultrasound uses ultrasound waves to capture the image. And thermal sensors uses heating patterns of the finger. Fingerprints are mainly classified into 5 types. These classifications are based on the fingerprint lines alignment. There are majorly three types of them. There are whole, right loop, left loop, tented arch, and arch. Fingerprint authentication system usually consists of five stages: the image acquisition from the sensor input, image processing, which removes some impurities in the image, feature extractions, extract the common features from the fingerprints, and template generation. When the template is generated, it is compared with a stored template that is already stored in the database, and the decision is made by a template matching algorithm. Some of the advantages and disadvantages will be discussed by my friend Sachin.
Hi. Coming to the advantages of face, it is easy to use the face recognition system. It is not a hardware based. We just need to install the software, and we need to have a basic camera to capture the image. So the most important advantage is the subject cooperation is not needed. That is, the ability to operate without physical contact or user complicity. So it is used in video surveillances for capturing or identifying the criminals. Coming to the disadvantages of face. So the disadvantage of face is mainly affected by the environmental and also the lighting effects. So if the person is coming for the second time and is posing for the camera, so it should be the same effective. I mean, the physiological features should not change. They may be changing due to the hairstyle, makeup, facial hair, eyeglasses, ads or scarves. Another disadvantage is the potential privacy use, because some of the users doesn't cooperate with the administrator for the time of enrollment and identification. Advantages of finger. Fingerprints are the most accepted and consistent algorithm because they are very unique even in twins. And fingerprints has many standards developed in of all the biometrics, because to achieve the interoperability between the different vendor systems. So it is better to use a fingerprint with password protection. Coming to the disadvantages, the system can be easily fooled. So easily copied or reproduced using the publicly available documentation and easy to acquire materials. So the same scanner used to authenticate one fingerprint person, and when another person comes, the previous mark of the oldest fingerprint person is left there. So it can be easily faked. So even if the fingerprint is not attached to the owner, it will permit authentication. Coming to the screen on the fingerprint scanners tend to retain abstraction buildup of oil residue from user's fingerprints. So it is difficult to obtain a good quality image if it is used continuously. Some of the social consequences. What happens when a biometric file is stolen? Biometric file is similar to a normal file which can be hacked. So it contains identity of the individuals. So it may lead to the misuse of the identity of the individuals. Another is that some of the biometric technologies are biased to some minorities depending upon the race, gender, age, and color of the skin. So it provides inconvenience when it is set up to access a public area such as parks. So one of the major challenges facing by the biometric systems is to provide access to the disability persons who do not have hands or retina or some eyes. Conclusion. In the near future, biometric will be used more for needs of increased technology, so government must gain the trust of people. So in order to gain, they have to conduct some awareness programs on the use of biometrics. Face recognition is widely used biometric. Face recognition uses the characteristics of face to recognize individuals. It is used to identify the criminals. Conclusion for fingerprint. Fingerprints are used for identification over a century because of their uniqueness and consistency. Fingerprint recognition is considered as a successful method of among the all. It is so successful because everyone has a unique one and easy to use. Just we need to place the finger on the scanner. That's it. Thank you.
My conclusion is, every biometric has its advantages and disadvantages. Through these biometrics, we are just trying to increase the security, and it does not ensure the security. I hope in future they will definitely succeed in this field by providing required and sophisticated resources.
So coming to me, after 9/11 incidents, the biometric security is a major technology to protect people from evil things. So the major issue in biometric technology is fraudulent. So many people trying to hack the systems and find to loopholes and making some evil things like 9/11 incidents. If you consider 9/11 incidents, the people who participated in that, they used to have more than 11 to 12 secured licenses. So it's kind of loophole in the biometric technology. So it need to be rectified. So for this, the people need to be mature in using biometric technology. Everyone must know what is the system they are using. So how can they can be protected? So everyone need to be mature in using the biometric technology so that there can be a possibility for avoiding loopholes or insecurity.
There are a lot of misconceptions about the biometric privacy. But right now, the people have started to bother about security rather than their privacy. And the government is also deploying large number of biometric systems across nation and worldwide to improve the security parameters. Let's see.
Any other conclusion? You're done. Okay, thank you. Now, any questions for this group? Any questions? I have one. Yes, here is one.
Have you heard about gait recognition technology, and is that becoming widely used now, or is that still in the developmental stages?
Actually, gait recognition technology is a behavioral, you know, that can be varied. So the person's walking style may be changed. If you consider a pregnant lady, so there will be a lot of change in her walking style. Some guys may be lean and they become fat, so that there will be a huge walking style differences. So, but it is still implementing. It may be used in, you know, or malls or somewhere, so that the customer, the person sitting in front of system may know how people coming into his shop. So it's still developing, but may not be more secure than other iris or retina.
Okay, thank you.
Other questions? I have a question. In your research, did you find any thread that ties for the one person all the biometric thing for the eye, iris, fingerprints, and other stuff? For the same person, is there any, like a DNA thing?
Yeah, we do have DNA biometric technology. So
the person has the same thing that appears in eye and fingerprint and...
Yeah, it comes under multi-biometric technology, you know, using
It is not yet implemented.
Okay. Now, this database has to be collected and put together. So not everybody is in it now.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay. Are they having plans to collect from everybody in the world?
Yeah.
But for the face recognition, without our consent, they capture our, profile pictures from Facebook or some social networking sites. The vendors do that.
Okay. Any other questions? So give them a big round of applause. And